On July 2nd, there is a total solar eclipse visible from Argentina and Chile. So imagine capturing all the phases and phenomena of the total solar eclipse, including the partial eclipse, the diamond ring, the Bayley's beads, the sun's corona, and the sun's chronosphere. And why not? Imagine a photo of the total solar eclipse with your favorite subject. For example, right above the 93 meters tall Cruz del Tercer Milenio in Coquimbo, Chile. Wouldn't be amazing? What do you think? Is it possible? Will it happen? Let's figure out. Hello, PhotoPillers, Rafael, the bar here. Today I'm gonna show you how to use PhotoPills to plan the July 2nd total solar eclipse so you can quickly figure out where to go and when to go to capture all the eclipse phases. Also, I'll show you how to plan a photo of the solar eclipse with your favorite subject, and I'll do it with an example. I plan a photo of the total eclipse with La Cruz del Tercer Milenio in Coquimbo, Chile. After watching this video, you will be able to plan any photo of a solar eclipse you imagine, to the last detail, including depth of field and field of view. Promised! And we start right now! As you'll see in a second, the band of totality of the solar eclipse goes from the Pacific Ocean to the Atlantic, crossing Chile and Argentina. The band of totality is key because it shows you where to go to capture all the phases of the total solar eclipse, including the partial eclipse and totality. And if you find a super powerful subject that falls within the band of totality, you can try to find a shooting spot to photograph the subject with the eclipse, like I'm gonna do now with the powerful Cruz del Tercer Milenio in Coquimbo, Chile. Ready? Because these are the 8 steps to plan the July 2nd total solar eclipse. Let's go! Step 1. Select the July 2nd total solar eclipse. Go to PhotoPills, tap on Planner, and as always, the red pin is placed on Menorca, our beautiful island. To plan the shot, the first thing you need to do is to select the eclipse you wish to plan. So tap on the Map Settings button and tap on the Eclipse layer. And here you have a table of all the moon and sun eclipses happening till 2050, including our eclipse, the July 2nd, 2018 total solar eclipse. On the table, notice that from the red pin position, the eclipse is not visible, so it is not visible from Menorca. Let's see where it is visible. Tap on the eclipse and switch on the eclipse map layer and tap on done to go back to the map. Now the date has been set to July the 2nd, 2019, the date of the eclipse. And if I zoom out, I'll have a better view of the eclipse information on the map. Here I have it. Very cool. So what you see here, the yellow, red and blue lines are the areas on the wall where you can see at least one phase of the eclipse. But if you wish to photograph all the phases of the eclipse, you need to go to a place that falls within the band of totality. And the band of totality is this dark band you see on the map that crosses Chile and Argentina. Step 2. Place the red pin to your desired location within the band of totality. I did my research and I found a cool subject in Coquimbo, in Chile. It's La Cruz del Tercer Milenio. It's pretty cool. Pretty cool structure. Here I have it. Right there. It falls within the band of totality, so from any spot in Coquimbo, I can photograph all the faces of the eclipse. Pretty cool. Also, I'll try to find the shooting spot to photograph the eclipse with my subject, with La Cruz del Tercer Milenio. So the first step is to place the red pin in Coquimbo so I can start applying the shot. So let's do a zoom in here. And let's say I want to place it right here. Cool. I have the red pin in Coquimbo and I see La Cruz del Tercer Milenio over there. Pretty cool. Now that we know where to go to photograph the eclipse, let's figure out when we should go to photograph it. Step 3. Figure out when the eclipse phases happen. Swipe the panel to the left until you get to panel number 10. This is the eclipse phases panel. This panel is telling you for the red pin position the times the different eclipse phases happen. For example, the phase of totality, when the moon covers completely the sun, begins at 4:38 and 14 seconds p.m. The eclipse is maximum at 4:39, 15 seconds p.m. and totality ends at 4:40 and 16 seconds p.m. So from the shooting spot, the moon will cover completely the sun for a bit more than 2 minutes. That's pretty cool. 2 minutes of totality. Tap and hold the times you see on the top panel to set the time of the eclipse phase in the planner. You can also change time with the time bar and see how the eclipse evolves at all time. That's pretty cool. I love it. I love this feature. Step 4. Figure out where the eclipse is happening in the sky. Have a look at the map now. At the beginning of totality, at 4:30 pm, the eclipse will be in the direction of this purple thin line you see on the map. If I change the time to the end of totality by tapping and holding on the time on the top panel, again, this purple thin line is telling me where the eclipse is happening. And setting the time when the eclipse is maximum, again, the eclipse azimuth line adjusts its position, showing me where the eclipse will happen when it's maximum. So on the map, I see where the eclipse will happen. But what's the elevation? You have the answer on panel number 3. So swipe the panels until you get to panel number 3. And here you can read the elevation of the sun and the moon. In this case, when the eclipse is maximum, the sun will be at an elevation of 13.63 degrees. When you're on the spot right where the red pin is, you can tap on the AR button and visualize where the eclipse is happening in the sky and the eclipse path, which is pretty cool. This view really helps a lot to understand where the eclipse will happen in the sky. Super easy. Well, if you're only interested in photographing the eclipse phases, you're done with the planning. You know where to go, when to go, and where the eclipse will happen in the sky, so you know where to frame the camera. Let's see now how to plan a photo of the total solar eclipse with your subject. Step 5. Place the black pin on your subject. As an example, let me plan the total solar eclipse when it's maximum and right above La Cruz del Milenio in Coquimbo, Chile. Let's find the shooting spot. Zoom in on your subject, in this case La Cruz del Tercer Milenio. And now let's place the black pin on the subject. Go to panel number 2 and tap on the button you see on the panel and drag and drop the black pin right on your subject. Like this. Pretty cool. Now zoom out to have a better view of the scene. Nice. Step 6. Find the shooting spot. Just by looking at the map, I see where my subject is, where the black pin is, and where the eclipse is happening. This is the direction of the purple thin line. So what I need to do is to find a shooting spot where I can see my subject. Nothing is blocking the view of my subject, and the eclipse works well with it. It could be behind my subject, perfectly aligned with it, or next to my subject, or above my subject. It all depends on your taste. Let's say that I want to photograph La Cruz del Milenio, my subject, with the eclipse right on top. Then I need to move the red pin in a way the eclipse will be aligned with my subject. For example, here. Let's see. More or less should be here. Let's have a look. Well, here it's almost aligned. Let's move it a bit south. For example, here. Great. From this location, yeah, the eclipse is perfectly aligned with my subject, which is pretty cool. Let's move on. I like to use Google Street View to double check that nothing is blocking the view of my subject from the red pin position. It works really, really well. Now it's time to check on the panel the altitude of the eclipse above my subject, above the ground level of my subject, where the black pin is. In this case, the altitude of the sun above the black pin is 382.8 meters. Knowing that La Cruz del Milenio is only 93 meters, the eclipse will happen too high in the sky, probably. If you want the eclipse to be closer to your subject, you'll have to move closer to your subject. So now it's a matter of trial and error, moving the red pin, getting closer to the subject, and checking the altitude of the eclipse above the black pin. Let me show you a trick that will save you a lot of time when planning the photo. Tap on the plus button, and tap on the expand azimuth lines button, this one. And now swap the pins. Tap again on the plus button and tap on the swap pins button. Cool. Here, what you have is this dashed line, which is telling you all the positions you can shoot from and get the eclipse aligned with your subject. Therefore, if I want to move closer to my subject, all I have to do is to move the black pin and get it closer. Let's see, for example, here, I could go, okay, imagine I want to shoot it from here. Okie dokie, a little bit more. Cool. And now, if I swap the pins again, I have the shooting spot and the eclipse is aligned with my subject. And in this case, from this shooting spot, the top panel is telling me that the sun altitude above the black pin is only 124.1 meters, which is pretty close to my subject, La Cruz del Tercer Milenio. It's much, much better in terms of composition. Always remember to double check that nothing is blocking the view of your subject from the red pin position. Use Google Street View or even Google Earth. Another option in the cities is to go on roof or building and shoot from there. That's the safest bet. For example, you could go to booking.com and try to find a hotel that allows you to shoot a nice photo of your subject and the eclipse. Shooting from the top of a building really helps in the cities. Step 7, check the size of the eclipse. How big, how large will be the eclipse compared to my subject? Well, the top panel is telling me that the shooting distance is 989.3 meters. This is the distance between the red pin and the black pin, where my subject is. And this distance gives me a sun size of 9.1 meters. To see the size of the eclipse on the map, just tap on the map settings button, tap on the sun layer, and switch on show sun size. Go back to the map, and now the azimuth line of the sun shows me the actual size of the sun. This is the size also of the eclipse, of course. Pretty cool. I love it. Step 8. Plan your field of view and depth of field. To plan the camera settings you need for a certain depth of field and field of view, switch on the depth of field calculator on the map. Tap on the map settings button and tap on depth of field calculator. And now go back to the map. Now on the map, I have the field of view and depth of field information. So with the Nikon Z6, focal length of 500 mil, aperture f8, focusing on my subject where the black pin is, shooting in landscape mode, and framing the subject. Let's change the framing. Let's align it with the black pin. Let's set always align with the black pin is the way I like to work. Here we have it. I have everything. I have all the info on the map. I know the field of view, so I know what will be captured in the frame. And I also have the depth of field information. For example, the hyperfocal information, in this case, the hyperfocal distance is 1.04K and it falls behind my subject. Therefore, if I'm focusing on my subject, which is a shorter distance, yes, I'll get my subject in focus, but the eclipse will be out of focus. Check where the depth of field far limit falls. So now on the map, you see the depth of field far limit, which falls at 19.59K. Which means that everything that falls behind this distance will be out of focus. So the eclipse will be out of focus. Therefore, it is not a good idea to focus at your subject in this case. Use the hyperfocal distance when focusing. Make sure that you're focusing at a distance that's larger than the hyperfocal. Let me give you an example. The hyperfocal is 1.04K. So if I focus at 1,200 meters, which is further away from the hyperfocal, in this case, my depth of field far limit falls in infinity, so the eclipse will be in focus. And my depth of field near limit falls at 557 meters, so the subject will be in focus. So great, I have everything now. I have my shooting spot, where the red pin is, I have my shooting date and time, July the 2nd, 2019, at 4:39 p.m. in this case, and I have my camera settings, my field of view, and my depth of field workout, so I make sure that everything will be in focus in the frame. Awesome! And that's it. This is how you can plan the July 2nd, 2019 total solar eclipse with PhotoPills, and also any other sun and moon eclipse. I put a link of the plan I just made in the description of this video, so you can import it onto PhotoPills. And if you wish to learn how to photograph the solar eclipse, I'm also leaving a link to our super eclipse guide in the description below. Check it out. Now tell me, what problems do you have when planning or shooting a solar eclipse? Comment below, I'm ready to help. And if you go and capture the photo I've just planned, please let me know, I wanna see the photos. Comment below. As always, if you go and capture it, leave no trace, let's take care of the planet. In the next video, I'm gonna plan another legendary photo. Don't miss it. subscribe and click all the bells to get notified when we'll release it. And I'll see you in the next video. And remember that you have the power to imagine, plan and shoot legendary photos. Bye.